Hi everyone, welcome to Whole Recaps. Today we're going to tell the story of the Memory Tutor. In the future, people live in a perfect society. Imagine there's no more fighting and no more pain. You wouldn't know the meaning of pain, the meaning of death. And the best thing is that everyone is equal. Schools are assigned by the state, jobs are assigned by the state, even wives and children are assigned by the state. You'll be given healthcare every day, a shot a day to strengthen your body and make sure you live happily until you retire. Of course, there's no such thing as a free lunch, and there's a price to pay for such a good social order. Living here, there are strict rules. You must comply with a pervasive listening system that keeps a close eye on violations. Anyone caught in the act will be banished. Where to, no one knows. Jonathan is an ordinary boy in a country like this. He's about to turn 12, and he's worried about his future. At the bar mitzvah, each child is given a lifelong career based on his or her personality. But Jonathan felt that he was no match for anyone else. On the day of the bar mitzvah, the elders in charge of the country announced everyone's occupations, but skipped him. This made Jonathan even more vain. "I don't deserve a job?" What he didn't expect was that the elder would give him the most important job in the country, to be a memory bearer. There's only one memory bearer in the whole country. It looks mysterious and high class. The next day, Jonathan reports to the office, which is a cabin on the edge of a cliff. Jonathan has heard that people have jumped off here before and disappeared. He meets his teacher, who tells him that you are not on a normal mission and not just one or two people. The memories I'm going to transmit to you are all the memories of the entire community before they were erased from memory. That was a long, long, long time ago. What our memories had been erased, and before Jonathan could react, he was transported to an icy landscape. It was the first time he'd ever seen snow. That's right. We can't have extreme weather in this country. If the crops freeze, people starve, and if they starve, they get angry, and if they get angry, they get unstable, and that's not good enough. Jonathan was surprised and delighted. He paddles up to the sled and is happy as can be. The ride was over. Jonathan's dream was over. He couldn't wait for more unknown memories. Back home, the doctor's father brought in a baby from the nursery. The baby was weak, and because it wasn't at a level where it could be sent out, it was being held in his home for the time being. In order to ensure balance, the world's unhealthy babies and old people are also exiled. This time, not only did he know what pain was, but he also suddenly saw colors under the teacher's transmission. That's right, color, literally. The color of this country has also been eliminated. What if someone discriminates because of a difference in skin color? Then society would be unstable again. Jonathan looked at the vibrant colors around him with an unspeakable joy. But unfortunately, his friends couldn't accept his joy. It was only after the teacher explained that the health supplement they injected every morning was actually an emotion control drug. With it, people can remain polite no matter how much they're stimulated. Having seen the world as it really is, Jonathan was inspired to find human emotion. So the next day, Jonathan started avoiding the injections. And sure enough, he could feel more things. In addition to the colors, the music, the excitement, the joy, he felt an unnameable emotion. He felt it for his family, for Fiona, and for his teacher. He couldn't find the words to describe it. The teacher told him it was love. If you want to eliminate hate, then you must also eliminate love, because they are interdependent. Jonathan, who was immersed in fond memories, did not know that the memories he had to take on by becoming a memory bearer also included the negative emotions of the annihilation of mankind. In a chance transmission, Jonathan gained early access to the memories of killing, death, and war. Growing up in a perfect world, Jonathan couldn't accept that the real society was so ugly and cruel. He frantically ran out of the cabin and back home. He couldn't look his family in the eye for the lies they were telling him. He tossed and turned between being exiled and sticking it out. The next day, Jonathan returned to the cabin. His teacher was worried about him. It turns out that the teacher's daughter was the last memory bearer. But she was exiled because she couldn't accept the cruel, heavy memories of the human race. What's even more horrifying is that when the teacher pulled up the video, Jonathan saw his own father injecting an unqualified baby. Within moments, the baby stopped moving. As his memory awakens, Jonathan realizes that the so-called exile is euthanasia. Their society has never known death, but buries the lives of others every day. His teacher told him of the legend of the memory bearers who could resurrect the human consciousness, but had to cross a distant frontier. There is a memory border there. Breaking the border would release all the memories that existed only in their minds. Jonathan was tempted. He returns home only to find to his horror that the adopted baby has been returned to the nursery because he failed the medical examination. He will be euthanized, just like the baby in the video. Jonathan went straight to the nursery, he rushed into the room, grabbed the baby and ran. But by this time, news of his infraction had reached the ears of the elders, and Jonathan was wanted all over the city. With the little baby in tow, he made a mad dash for the borders of memory. The motorcycle leapt off a cliff and disappeared from the sight of his pursuers. He knows that Fiona and his teacher, who helped him escape, are facing euthanasia. Reaching the border and releasing human memories was his last hope. He carried the baby across the desert and was trapped in the snowy mountains. On the other side, the eye of the needle was about to penetrate Fiona's skin. Jonathan and the baby are exhausted. They found a sled on a hillside near the border. Jonathan sat on it, and with the last of his strength, he paddled towards the border. He wanted to return to humanity the memories and emotions that had been forced into dust, whether it was sadness or joy, love or hate. The warmth of family or the heartbeat of love. He would bring the land back to life, bring humanity back to life. Did Jonathan make it to the other side of the border? The movie doesn't give us an answer. Maybe he did, and he brought color back to the world. A new respect for life, a new love and a new pain. But maybe he fell halfway across the border and ended up being another legend lost in utopia. The Memory Bearer is based on an anti-utopian novel written by Lewis Lorry for young adults. The novel designs a seemingly perfect utopia. He eliminates all the things that mankind sees as negative: violence, poverty, hunger, discrimination. But there is a side to the world that is even worse than the real world. Perhaps our world is destined to be imperfect, we are destined to have human weaknesses, we are destined to have envy, greed, and prejudice. But compassion, kindness, and reverence for life are also destined to shine through. Maybe the important thing is not how to get rid of imperfections, but how to live with those imperfections. After reading the story, which world do you prefer? I think you have your own answer in your mind. Please let me know in the comment section. Well, that's all for this issue of Whole Recaps. See you in the next issue.